The fortunes of catfish farmers in recent times have risen substantially, and this could outstrip the tilapia market. This is debatable. My name is Enyona Manye, and this is Ghanaian Farmer TV show. In our previous episodes, we brought you a lot of educational information on tilapia farming. But this week, let's also put some spotlight on catfish farming and how well it is doing in Ghana. My guest for today is a young man by name Andrews, a level 300 student in University of Ghana, studying Bachelor of Science in Agriculture. Let's get to understand and appreciate what inspired him to go into agribusiness. He will tell us this and many more. This program is proudly brought to you by Lizzie Tomato Mix. Get interactive on our social media platform, Facebook, Instagram, LinkedIn, and on YouTube, The Ghanaian Farmer. I'm going for a quick break. Now, when I come back, Andrews tell us more that we need to know about catfish farming. Agriculture is the food basket of a nation and therefore the heart of Ghana. It contributes up to 54% of Ghana's GDP and accounts for over 40% of export earnings, at the same time providing over 90% of the food need of the country. This is due to the hard work of the Ghanaian farmer. Join me, Enyona, as we visit the farm, the market, and agricultural-based industries. That's not all. We will also bring you recipes for finger-licking delicacies made with crops grown by the Ghanaian farmer.
The Ghanaian Farmer. Business tilling the land.
Thanks for staying. If you're just tuning in, you're watching The Ghanaian Farmer on Joy Prime. My name is Enyona, and our focus for today is catfish farming. Andrews, thanks for joining us.
Thank you so much.
And thank you so much for inviting us over to your farm. Now, you are a student on campus.
Yes,
level 300.
Yeah.
How did this start for you?
It started up as an idea of benefiting human nutrients.
Okay.
Yeah. So it started during the COVID time where we were on a lockdown.
That was last year?
Yeah.
Okay.
So I had these thoughts and I was still going through doing a little research and all that until I decided, no, let me finalize this. And I started early November.
Late November. That is last year, 2020.
Yes.
After reading around, watching videos and all that. Then you made an informed decision.
Yeah.
But what triggered you about catfish farming and not any other? We have tilapia and others. So why catfish?
Catfish because I went around and I saw that people are interested in tilapia.
Yes, we consume a lot of tilapia.
Yes. Mm-hmm. So I decided to search on its benefits, comparing it to catfish.
Okay.
And I saw that it's far better. Catfish nutrients and importance is far better than that of tilapia.
Right.
Yeah.
Okay.
So I decided, no, let me go in for catfish.
I see.
Yeah.
Okay. So I'll start with the structure. How many feet is this?
This is just 6 feet.
6 feet.
Yeah.
Does it go down?
Not so down.
Okay.
So calculating from here.
Mm.
Downwards. So here's about three.
Okay.
Down is also three.
Yeah. Did you cement the ground?
Yes, I did.
It is cemented?
Yeah.
I see. Okay. So after you put up the structure, you put water. Is it like pipe water?
Yes, it's a natural water source. Mm. Yes. Coming from the ground. Usually we know it to be salty.
Okay.
But I had it tested and all that, but it's fine.
Okay, so it wasn't the normal pipe water?
No.
Okay, so after that, what did you do next? Take us through the process.
Okay, so I had the pond constructed. Then after that, I had to, because the cement contains a little of acid and all that, I had to neutralize it and get it to the neutral form.
Okay.
So I went in for plantain leaves and all that. Mm. Then I placed them inside and I added a little water so that it will let it be uniform inside. So after that, then I brought everything out again.
Mm.
Then I pumped in my fresh water.
Okay.
Yeah.
Before
you moved in. Yes.
Okay. So Did you start with eggs, like, you know, the poultry farmers, or you started with fingerlings?
Yes. Because I was not experienced, I started with juvenile. They are a little older than their fingerlings.
I see.
Yeah.
Okay, so we have the juvenile, then we have the fingerlings.
Yes.
Okay. So the juvenile is how many weeks old?
They are like 3 weeks old.
3 weeks old.
Yes.
But the fingerlings are like...
1 week. Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
Right. So how many of the juvenile did you buy to start?
I started with 500.
500?
Yeah.
Okay. And how much was that?
The 500 is exactly 500 cedis.
500 cedis.
Yes.
Okay. I didn't ask for the cost to construct the pond. How much was that?
The cost to construct was close to 2,600.
To construct the pond?
Yeah. Because there was a fault somewhere, so we had to break
it. So 2,500 or
2,600
for the pond?
Yes.
And then 500 cedis for the juvenile?
Yeah.
Making 3,100 Ghanaian cedis. As a student, how did you come by the capital to start?
With this, I introduced this idea to a partner, or let me say a friend, who is already ahead of me.
Right.
Yes. So he was quite supportive and encouraged me in doing it.
So you raised the money
from him.
From him.
Yeah.
Okay. I see. So when you got the finger licks and then kept them in here, how long did it take for you to do your first sales?
It took me 6 months.
6 months?
Yes.
And then you were ready for your first sale?
Yes. People were demanding, but I don't like to sell
prematurely. Okay.
Yes.
So you waited for 6 months and then you started selling.
Selling them.
Now let's talk about the feed. You said it's called what?
It's called Ala Aqua Feed.
Ala Aqua Feed.
Yeah.
What makes up this feed? What and what goes into it?
We have a content of carbohydrates.
Okay.
Yes. Millets.
Mm-hmm.
And a little of fish protein.
Okay.
Yes, they call it fish protein because it's the back of other fishes which are already dead.
Mm.
Yes, that's a protein source for them.
Mm.
So as you pour it inside, it makes it smell like them.
Mm.
So they find it interesting eating
to eat
soup.
It.
Yeah.
I see. Now, is this locally produced here?
We have locally produced one, but this one is from Ala Aqua. That's in Egypt.
Okay.
Yes.
Okay. So how much is this bag?
This bag is 106 cedis.
16 cedis.
Yes.
And how many of those do you buy to feed your...
At every stage, we change it.
Okay.
Yes. So at every stage, I buy 106. The only time I bought more than that was the bigger bag.
Mm.
That was close to... That was 240 cedis, yes.
Okay.
That was when they were... 4 months.
Mm.
Yes. During that time, they eat a lot.
So between 1 month to 4 months, what kind of feed did you give them?
I was giving them the 2 mm. Then I came to 2.5 mm.
Okay.
Yes.
And then before, this is the last one.
Yes, this is the 8 mm.
Okay. Yes. So this is when they are matured. Then you can give them this one.
Yes.
I see.
So they are done.
Okay. How many times do you feed them in a day?
As matured as they are, I feed them once a day.
Once a day.
Yes.
I see. Okay. How many types of breed do we have here?
In my pond, I have 3 types of breed. The African catfish, the local one, and the foreign Egyptian one.
Okay.
Yes.
So you have 3. Or we have more than 3 catfish.
We have more than 3. But me over here,
you have just 3. Okay. Why did you select that 3? Is it because that is what is in demand in the market? Or they don't really care about the breed?
They don't really care about the breed.
Mm.
But I do because some grow bigger than the other.
Okay.
The local African one.
Uh-huh.
You see, it's quite bigger. This one.
Easy, catfish, easy, easy. Okay, so this one is which one?
This is the African one.
Okay. And then this the big one.
This is the local one.
Ah.
Yes. And you know our local products.
Mm. We like big ones.
We like very big
ones. I see. Interesting. Now, I wanted to find out something. Do catfish lay eggs? How do they reproduce?
Yes, they lay eggs as well. The same breeding, male, female, that's the same way they do it.
Okay.
So they have pupula.
Uh-huh.
That's their reproduction, should I say, system.
Right.
Yes. So that's where you get, so in the female, you get it coming from the babies. Okay. I think the eggs, the eggs coming from there.
Okay. Now, I know that with fowls, you see the male running after the female. Now, how do your these people? How do they do their thing?
They are so silent in everything they do.
I see.
Yes.
Secret people.
That's something you should choose to call them.
I see. Okay. Now let's talk about the difference between this catfish I'm seeing here and the one we see in the regular mud outside? What's the difference?
Okay, so the locally reared one over here, we give them a specific type of feed.
Okay.
So with that, you can calculate and know that it is growing, it is not growing.
Okay.
But those we see in the mud, they just eat anything they find. Mm. Even though they eat anything, but if you are eating anything and your diet is not specific, your growth is always different and retarded.
I see. Now, when you bring this catfish out, okay, I know the ones in the mud, they can be hidden there for very long time. When it rains, then they even come up, people to catch them anyhow.
Yes.
Now,
yes.
With this one, when it comes out and it's not in water, how long does it stay for before it starts to get weakening and probably die?
Okay. So when it's not in water, because of their slippery nature, they're able to produce water from their own body. Yes. So that's their source of survival whilst not in water.
Okay.
Yes. So they can be outside close to 45 minutes.
Oh, okay.
And over.
Before it dries up.
Before it dries up. And even with that, if you put it back in water, it will come back.
It will still survive.
Yes.
I see. Now let's talk about profitability. Nobody goes into business without considering or doing calculations with regards to profitability.
Yes.
Apart from the nutritional value that we get from consuming catfish, how is the sales going so far since you've started from last year, late last year, November till now? How many times have you sell and how is the response from consumers like?
Okay, so I haven't sold so much, but so far for the number of them I've sold, the responses are catfish is really good.
Okay.
Yes, because people, it comes to people like a surprise. Hey, is this catfish? Because of how they look, people are always scared and all that, so they don't find interest. So until you make them interested, yes, so far my customers, those I've sold to, they are the ones making demands.
Okay.
So I'm just trying to get more people to buy so that they also make demands.
I see.
Because in Ghana here, we are all used to tilapia and salmon.
Yes.
But catfish is best.
Okay, I see. Right, so catfish is best. And so far, sales is picking up gradually for him. This is young Andrews because he's really young. But I'm so excited. I was, you know, touched and in a hurry to interview him after I saw his post on social media. This is what I'm talking about. You're still watching The Ghanaian Farmer on Joy Prime. My name is Zenyunam. I'm going for a quick breather. I'll be right back. I met Calvin in town. When I first met him, it was love at first sight. The feeling was mutual.
You see how I treat your father?
Mm-hmm.
The father loves me so much because I always give him good food.
I love Kelvin, and with all the stress from his family, I didn't want to lose him. So I decided to act fast.
Mother! Mm?
Where's the wedding coming up?
It wasn't Gigi or anything. Lizzie tomato mix was just what I needed to prove my worth. At Depot will fear for eating, and I have all that in just one pack. Lizzie tomato mix makes food taste delicious.
Lizzie tomato mix can be found in some shops nationwide. This advertisement has been vetted and approved by the FDA.
Thanks for staying with us. You're still watching The Ghanaian Farmer. Today, our spotlight is on catfish farming. And I'm still speaking with Andrews. Andrews, before going on break, I wanted to find out the money you've invested. Have you recouped the money and even making profit? And paid your friend, of course.
Okay, so as at now, I have made almost close to what I've invested. Yes.
Okay.
And there are still more in there.
I see.
So probably I know I can make it.
Okay.
Yeah. And even bring in another set of fishes.
Yeah. I see. Now, the water around the fish, if I should say, do you change it?
Yes.
How often do you change it?
I change it every 1.5 months.
Every 1.5 months? You have to
Based on the scent in it.
Ah, so you have to monitor the scent that comes out.
Yes.
Why does this stink? I think it has a little bit of a foul odor. Why is it like that?
It's because of how they rub themselves against each other. Yes, and their feces. So it creates this form of foam in it. So this foam grabs their feces and that brings out the smell. So when it is too much, then the odor comes out.
Yes.
So you have to change it with time. Sometimes it can go close to 2 months. They are fine because there is no foul odor in it.
So during such times, what happens to the fish when you're moving the water out?
They are okay. Because with them, in every condition, they survive.
I see.
Yes.
Okay. So when you move the water out, how long will it take before you fill it with fresh one?
And when I move them out, I try my best and clean inside. I bring in fresh water.
So it means you bring all the fish out?
No, the fishes, all the fishes are inside. I just bring all the water out.
Okay. I see. Now let's move on. So with the way the consumption of catfish, it's now rising though.
Yes.
But how are you ensuring that you, you know, make a lot of awareness creation for people to understand and appreciate why they should consume more of catfish?
Yes. So anytime I post and speak about to people, I tell them about its benefits, like the low cholesterol content of it. Its ability to make the to fill in cartilage in our bones. Yes, I make it aware to those.
You talk more about the health benefits of consuming it.
Of consuming
it. Okay.
That's what interests people when they're about eating. Yes. So.
I see. Now, we'll talk about the profitability. Do you, for future purposes, or for anybody watching you who might want to start this, do you foresee profit making in this sector?
Yes. There is a lot of profit in catfish. Because very soon, I'm seeing a very high demand of it.
Okay.
Just because people will adapt and get to know about it.
Okay.
Because if you don't know, you wouldn't find interest. But if you get to know, you will find interest.
I see.
Yes. And probably change your way. Maybe you like to eat tilapia. But if you find the benefits of catfish, you will change your mind.
What kind of weather or climate condition is good for catfish, even though they are in water?
Okay, for their conditions, if it's so cold, they eat a lot. So with that, they need just any average temperature and normal temperature.
Right.
But when it's very cold, they will eat so much.
I see. So lukewarm kind of weather is very good for
them. Very good for them.
I see. So they will not eat too much of your feed.
Else you'll continue to buy feed.
I see. But is the feed expensive?
The feed is starting from their little stage. They eat 2 mm. That's 106 cedis.
Okay.
So it is only 4 mm stage where it's close. It's 240 cedis.
Okay.
The rest are all 106 cedis. 106 cedis.
Right.
Yeah.
So how are you balancing school and this?
Yes.
Are you on campus or you leave home and going to campus?
I'm on campus.
So who takes care of the farm whilst you're away?
I have a personal assistant who is a brother to me.
Okay.
Yes. So he is usually at home more than I am.
Okay.
So, but anytime I'm on vacation, I come and I take care of them myself.
So you don't even come on weekends?
No, it's on vacation.
So when someone wants to buy, who then sells it?
I am the one who comes.
Ah, so during sales you come?
Sales, I come.
Ah, you see your life. Okay, interesting. I see. Now, what and what should I take into consideration, assuming somebody wants to go into catfish farming?
Yes.
What are some of the technicalities you have learned that you can share with a novice who wants to go into catfish farming?
Okay, so with catfish, they're able to survive in all conditions.
Okay.
So you just have to be able to handle them and make sure they don't overcrowd in your pond and they're able to feed enough. That is all.
Okay. Apart from posting on social media, which other means do you use to advertise or get people to come and buy your product?
Yes, I have posters I post around. Yes, so if you go around this place, you will see there are a few around.
Okay.
Yes, and anytime I get a chance and a platform to speak, I end talking about my
customers. Who are your main customers or clients?
My clients, I usually target old people.
Okay.
Yes, because it's very beneficial to them.
For the aged.
For the aged.
I see. How about the restaurants and the hotels? Do they buy from you as well?
Yes, they make demands, but their demands are too high.
That you cannot supply?
Yes, and they need it consistently.
Okay.
So for the second set that comes, I'm supplying a restaurant.
I see.
Yes.
Okay. Now, what have you realized has been one of the challenges for those of you in catfish farming? What proposal or suggestions would you have given to stakeholders to help in improving the sector?
Okay. So I would say stakeholders should just step in and fund the little that are interested in catfish. Because if you are not interested, you can't do it. So they should fund us and probably create a community where if you need catfish, you just make a call. That is all.
Okay.
Yes.
I see. Another interesting thing. What makes catfish so interesting and exciting? You said it's easy. It's one of the easiest farming to do. Why did you say that?
It's one of the easiest farming to do because after they grow from the juvenile stage, your feeding is monitored and you don't have any stress. The only thing you do is change water, bring in new water, change water, bring in new water, then you feed them.
That's all?
That's all.
Simple?
Very simple.
Wow. Okay. So, apart from selling it fresh to people, what other value do you add to the catfish?
Yes.
I mean, what do you do? You told me you grill.
Yes.
What else do you do?
I smoke it.
Okay.
Into the core form, which we locally know as the
akosombo. Okay.
Now.
Yeah. Yes.
So with the smoked one, that's the core form. Yeah. That's the akosombo nam.
Okay.
Then we grill it in foil. Yeah.
So do you get more of the grilling orders too, or you mostly get a fresh
mostly
one?
Is the fresh one they buy. Yes, the grill demand is not so high because most of them prefer to buy it from the restaurants who are into grilling it.
What was the plan, the future plan like? I didn't even ask the name of your farm. Do you have a name for it?
Yes, I have.
Have you registered it?
Not yet. That's
you
why
have
I
to.
Mention.
You have to. You can't run your farm like an informal business, okay?
Okay.
This is business. So you need to register it.
Yeah.
So the name again was what?
The Nations Vivarium.
Nations
Vivarium.
Hey, we didn't get cracker. All right. So when I saw John Dumelo posting your videos, it was really heartwarming to see a young person like you wanting to go into catfish farming. And I must say congratulations.
Thank you so much.
To you. So are you training others or encouraging others on campus to also consider going into agriculture?
Yes. So as of now, I have one person who is already rushing into it. Yes. Because he has an available land which he was thinking of what to do.
Okay.
So until he saw me do this, he said, no, I have to mentor him go into this.
Okay.
Yes.
Oh, well done. That is really good. So viewers, a lot of insightful conversation here on Ghanaian Farmer with Andrews, who has been doing this since last year, November thereabout, and it's going well. He's excited. I mean, the excitement on his face tells you that he's enjoying what he's doing. Coming up, it's 60 seconds on our break. When we come back, we'll wrap up all on catfish farming here on the Ghanaian Farmer. Andrews, we are about concluding on an interview.
Okay.
Now, I realize that some of the catfish has red eye.
Yes.
Another one has black.
Yeah.
Why?
So, the eye, the black is the normal color, eye color of them.
Uh-huh.
Yes. So, when it's getting red, they are stressed.
Ah.
Yes.
Oh, I see. quickly, are there some infections that affect catfish as well?
For now, I would say no.
Okay.
Because so far, none of them has died.
In the pond?
Yes. They die in the pond.
Okay.
Because they chew
each other. Hey! By you too.
But they don't die with a sickness.
Mm.
I know of. If not, they would have been all gone.
How can you be chewing your fellow catfish? Now, are there best seasons that your catfish, as a farmer, your catfish should be ready to meet a high demand market so far?
So far.
Because I know, say, season poultry people, December markets.
Yes.
So you too, have you monitored the seasons or the festive seasons? We have to know which one is best for you.
Yes. I started November.
Okay.
So I realized people started, because as soon as I started marketing.
Okay.
So people started making demand the next month.
Right.
And they are young.
Uh-huh.
I can't sell.
Yeah.
So I realized possibly any festive season I can sell.
I see.
Depending on who hears it.
Okay. Yes. Now, there are more of your colleagues out there who are unemployed. And they are waiting for government to create jobs for them and all that. What have you got to say to these people?
You don't necessarily have to wait. If you have a colleague doing something, just try, talk, and listen to what he has for you. Probably the business he or she is into will not be big, but give the helping hand. Probably it will get to a point where everybody will be employed. Yes. Because if we are all waiting for government, jobs are not being created as at now. So for now, we need to create our own jobs. I have started something.
Right.
And there is a chance for everybody to join me.
Right.
I'm always and every day waiting for everybody who is going to join me. So we do this together.
And your lecturers are where you do this?
I have only one lecturer who is away.
Why haven't you told them? You need to market to them.
I told one because he's the one who teaches or lectures that course.
Okay.
Yes, I don't know how it will sound to the others.
Uh-huh.
Yes, because I didn't inform anybody. Because I wanted to surprise them with what they taught me.
Okay.
Yes, I started this before they even taught me. They just taught me last 2 months.
Okay.
Yes, so when I started this, I informed them, was like, it's a great job. So he's also starting.
I see.
Yes.
Interesting. Good one. All right, so viewers, that brings us to the end of our interview today on catfish farming. And I did this with Andrews.
Kutani.
Hey, Kutani. And he is a level 300 student at Legon. He's studying Bachelor of Science in Agriculture. And this is so inspiring. So I'm sure they are great ministry. These are the people you should be looking out for and supporting them. My name is Zenyanam, and many thanks to my proud sponsor, Lizzy Tomato Mix, for doing this with us for past 1 year. And our initiative is still on Support the Farmer Initiative. If you have anything you want to support a farmer with, if you want to invest into Andrew's farm, are you available for that?
Yes.
Someone wants to invest into your farming.
I'm always available.
Right, so he's open for investment. How do we find you on social media?
On social media, Twitter, Catfishura.
Okay.
Snap, Catfishura.
Okay.
Then WhatsApp, 054-0563-664.
Okay, I'll bring you my invite for that one. So thank you so much for watching. I'll see you next week.